Our today's presentation is on MATLAB simulation of bi-directional battery charger using buck boost converter. This is the basic topology of a bi-directional buck boost converter. This circuit works like a buck converter during battery charging operation and works like a boost converter during battery discharging operation. Now I will give you the specifications of the converter. The input voltage is 800 volt. Bus capacitance is 1000 microfarad. Switching frequency is 5 kHz. Value of filter inductance is 13 mH. Value of filter capacitance is 20 microfarad. Battery nominal voltage is 360 volt. Battery rating is 150 Ah. Total rated power is 10 kW. This is the controller block diagram used for the simulation. We use API controller to regulate the battery current during charge and discharge operation. Reference value of current is positive for charging and negative for discharging. Remaining things are same for both the operations. Now I will briefly explain the design of the converter. For the design, I consider the circuit as a buck converter in the battery charging mode. Specifications of the converter you can see on the screen. The value of inductance is given by Vout into Vin minus Vout, all divided by I ripple into FSW into Vin. That is, L is equal to 360 into 800 minus 360 divided by 3 into 5000 into 800. Which gives L is equal to 13 mH. Now value of capacitance is given by C is equal to I ripple divided by 8 into FSW into V ripple. That is, C is equal to 3 divided by 8 into 5000 into 0.36. Which gives C as 20 microfarad. Now we open the MATLAB and start doing the simulation. First add a DC voltage source. Set its amplitude 800 volt. Add a series RLC branch. This is the input bus capacitance. Set its series resistance, 1E rise to minus 4 and capacitance 1000 microfarad. Now add a MOSFET. This is the output filter inductor. Set its series resistance, 1E rise to minus 4 and inductance 13 mH. This is the output filter capacitor. Set its series resistance, 1E rise to minus 4 and capacitance 20 microfarad. Now add a current measurement block. This block is used to measure the battery current. Now add a battery. Flip the battery block to make the connections easier. Add a go-to block. This is used to label the battery current. Name it as IBAT. Now add a bus selector. Add battery voltage, current, and SOC into the bus. Add another go-to block. Label the battery voltage, current, and SOC using this block. Name this block as VBAT. Name this block as I bat 1. And name this block as SOC. Now add a constant block. Here we set the reference value of the required current.
For time being,
set the reference as 30 ampere. Now add a sum block. Change the sign of sum block to plus minus. Now connect the battery current to sum block. Add a PID controller. Set KP as 1.5 and KI as 25. Limit the PI controller output between 0 and 0.95. Now add a PWM generator. Set the switching frequency 5 kHz and sample time 1E rise to minus 6. Now add a logical operator. Set the operator type as NOT. Add a go-to block. Name this block as PWM1. And name this one as PWM2. Now connect the PWM signals to the corresponding gate terminal of the MOSFET. Now add a display block. Connect the battery voltage, current and SOC to the display. Now add a scope. Add battery current to the scope. Add a power guide block. Open configuration settings. Set solver type ODE23T. Open power guide block. Set simulation tie discrete and sampling time 1E rise to minus 6. I forgot to change the battery properties. Now I will open the battery and change it. Set the battery type lead acid. Set nominal voltage 360 volt. Set rated capacity 150 Ah. Set initial SOC 50% and battery response time 1 second. Set simulation run time 2 seconds. Now run the simulation. Here you can see the battery current, which is same as our reference value. Now we change the reference to 25 amps. So the current now has changed to 25 amps. Now we'll change to 15. So the actual current also changed to 15. We'll try 5 amps also. So for all the changes, the closed loop control working properly. I will also show you the battery current waveforms. This is the battery current waveform for different reference values. Now to make the circuit operate in battery discharge mode, we need to make reference value negative. So I will make the value minus 30 and run the simulation. You can see that battery current has changed to 30 amps with negative sign. Since we are discharging the battery, the voltage is coming down. Now we'll try different reference values. So for all the reference values, the output is coming properly. This is the battery current during the entire operation. This is the end of this presentation. Thanks for watching.